Isn't this just beautiful, guys? I've just made this wall art and I'm quite happy with the way that it's turned out. I wasn't actually thinking it would turn out this way, but looking at it now, I am so proud of myself and I cannot wait to share with you guys how I made this. And it didn't take me a long time to make. It was so easy to make, super affordable as well. So yes, I'm very happy with this and I actually feel like doing the happy dance, but we're not going to be doing that, no. Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how I made my beautiful wall art. It is super duper easy to make and it is really affordable. Anyone can make it. And if you would like to see how I made the wall art, keep watching. For this project you will need cocktail stirrers, some glue sticks, the glue gun, spray paint in black, mirror, and a plate holder. So this plate holder is gonna get sprayed into black. I'll just go ahead and do just that and I'll be right back. I ended up spraying the underplate with coated paint. Notice that I missed out the middle because that part will be covered by the mirror anyway, so really not necessary to spray that. Now it's time to start gluing the cocktail stirrers. I used the rim as a guide to lay down the stirrers all the way around. Just eyeball it and leave about an inch gap between the stirrers, making sure the flat end of the stirrer lays flat. Once the first layer is done, you can add the second layer about an inch down from the first one until you complete the whole process again. Now for the third layer, because the wall art is already wide enough, I didn't want to add any more width to it, so I decided to cut off about 2 inches of the stirrers before positioning them where I want them to be. So you can easily just snap it off or use a kitchen scissors like I have done and go ahead and just place down your cocktail stirrers. I'm using the all-purpose white glue here to add additional reinforcement to the hot glue. Make sure you add a generous amount and just leave it to dry for 24 hours before you go on to the next stage. The glue is now completely dry and we can move on to the next stage. Because the plate has a groove in the middle, I'm adding cardboard pieces to act as a surface for the mirror to glue to. So go ahead and add a generous amount of glue and stick them down to the bottom of the plate. I Add weighted items and allow to dry for another 24 hours. We are ready for the final part, which is the mirror. Now, before you go ahead and put your mirror, add a generous amount of glue to the back of the cardboard cuttings and add a little bit to your mirror as well if you wish before you place down your mirror. And voila, we have our wall art. Now finally, to prevent your mirror from scratching, add a kitchen towel and add some of your weighted items in the house and allow the glue to dry on. There we have it, our final product. Let me know if you like it as much as I do. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, what are you waiting for? Come on, hit the subscribe button below. Thank you for watching, guys. That's it for today. If you have any questions regarding the wall art or any questions at all, make sure you drop them below and I'll try my best to answer your questions.